And here we are again. It's, you know the intro already. It's not much different yet.
Open the gate. We are heading into the valley.
A lot of people think dwarves look awkward. I like to think of dwarves as little powerhouses. You know, little balls of power.
Pulses are coming faster now. The larger the breach grows, the more rifts appear, the more demons we face.
How did I survive the blast?
They said you stepped out of a rift, then fell unconscious. They say a woman was in the rift behind you. No one knows who.
Hide a little bit.
It's over.
Drop your weapon now.
It's a big sword.
All right, have it your way.
Wait. I cannot protect you, and I cannot expect you to be defenseless. I should remember you agreed to come willingly.
Yeah, I think an axe would look a lot better, because it's the length of the sword that makes it kind of look awkward.
At the forward camp, or fight.
So.
We are on our own for now.
If I can get an axe later, I will. Because the sword looks strange, but that's only because it's this lengthy, thin thing. I think an axe will look very nice, though.
Them, we may gain the advantage.
You can flank them, Cassandra.
Up on the hill. It attacks from a distance.
Look, they have magic resistance. I think that's helping me survive that. sure I don't miss anything. Because my very first playthrough with Corvina, I missed some extra gear, what have you, which I prefer not to miss.
What did you do?
I did nothing. The credit is yours.
At least this is good for something.
Whatever magic opened the breach in the sky also placed that mark upon your hand. I theorized the mark might be able to close the rifts that have opened in the breach's wake. And it seems I was correct.
Meaning it could also close the breach itself?
Possibly. It seems you hold the key to our salvation.
Good to know. Here I thought we'd be ass deep in demons forever.
I just love Varric.
Varric Tethrys, rogue, storyteller, and occasionally unwelcome tag along.
Are you with the Chantry, or...?
Was that a serious question?
Technically, I'm a prisoner, just like you.
I brought you here to tell your story to the Divine. Clearly, that is no longer necessary.
Yet, here I am. Lucky for you, considering current events.
It's good to meet you, Varric.
You may reconsider that stance in time.
Oh, I'm sure we'll become great friends in the valley, Chuckles.
Absolutely not. Your help is appreciated, Varric, but...
Have you been in the valley lately, Seeker? Your soldiers aren't in control anymore. You need me.
Ugh.
My name is Solus, if there are to be introductions. I am pleased to see you still live.
He means I kept that mark from killing you while you slept.
Then I owe you my thanks.
Thank me if we manage to close the breach without killing you in the process. Cassandra, you should know, the magic involved here is unlike any I've seen. Your prisoner is no mage. Indeed, I find it difficult to imagine any mage having such power.
Understood. We must get to the forward camp quickly.
Well... Bianca's excited.
This way, down the bank. The road ahead is blocked.
We must move quickly.
Yeah, last time I missed a bunch of items that I don't want to miss this time. There already. Right. And there's something up there as well. Yeah, the sword, I mean, like I said, dwarves are powerful, stocky. I mean, it makes sense that she can wield it. It just looks kind of odd, I have to admit. Gathering resources. Life ward item, not. I didn't design her to look beautiful so much as interesting and kind of
so
tough.
Let me guess, so, yeah. Fellow surface dwarf may be part of the Carta.
What makes you say that?
I can tell a proper Orzammar dwarf from 20 paces. Also, you have that shifty smuggler look to you.
You have keen eyes.
And an enormous mouth.
and clever hands. It's all part of my charm.
My magic cannot stop your mark from growing further. For your sake, I suggest we hurry.
Solus, we're hurrying.
So, are you innocent?
I don't remember what happened.
That'll get you every time. Should have spun a story.
That's what you would have done.
It's more believable, and less prone to result in premature execution.
Missed the shatter opportunity.
Animated through all this.
She's resourceful, Seeker.
We will see for ourselves at the forward camp. We're almost there.
Fairly useless, mind you. So combat's going a bit smoother because. Rather more smoothly because I have some experience now. If you're injured. I'll drink one too. Okay.
For the moment.
Now, I hope that it's not bugged because I plan on using the Vanguard chain quite a bit. Literally the chain as well as the tree perk system, whatever, but yeah. Let's hope it works. Because I really like that ability when it does work.
Whatever that thing on your hand is, it's useful.
Ah, here they come.
You made it. Chancellor Roderick. This is...
I know who she is. As Grand Chancellor of the Chantry, I hereby order you to take this criminal to Valroyo to face execution.
Order me? You are a glorified clerk, a bureaucrat.
And you are a thug, but a thug who supposedly serves the Chantry.
We serve the most holy, Chancellor. As you well know.
Justinia is dead! We must elect a replacement and obey her orders on the matter.
Isn't closing the breach the more pressing issue?
You brought this on us in the first place! Call a retreat, Seeker. Our position here is hopeless.
We can stop this before it's too late.
How? You won't survive long enough to reach the temple, even with all your soldiers.
We must get to the temple. It's the quickest route.
but not the safest. Our forces can charge as a distraction while we go through the mountains.
We lost contact with an entire squad on that path. It's too risky.
Listen to me. Abandon this now, before more lives are lost.
How do you think we should proceed?
Now you're asking me what I think.
You have the mark.
And you are the one we must keep alive. Since we cannot agree on our own.
This time I'm going to charge, because that's just Gunhild's personality.
I say we charge. I won't survive long enough for your trial. Whatever happens, happens now.
Liliana, bring everyone left in the valley. Everyone.
On your head be the consequences, Seeker.
Hope my hook works this time. Okay, that worked. Guys.
Before. You are becoming quite proficient at this.
Let's hope it works on the big one.
Lady Cassandra, you managed to close the rift. Well done.
Do not congratulate me, Commander. This is the prisoner's doing.
Is it? I hope they're right about you. We've lost a lot of people getting you here.
I can't promise anything, but I'll try my best.
That's all we can ask. The way to the temple should be clear. Liliana will try to meet you there.
Then we'd best move quickly. Give us time, Commander.
Make her watch over you, for all our sakes. Temple of Sacred Ashes. What's left of it?
That is where you walked out of the Fade, their soldiers found you. They say a woman was in the rift behind you. No one knows who she was.
Give Varric his... No. I already got a helmet, so Varric gets a scout hat. Go Varric. Nope, scout coat. Scout hat. There we go.
Have your men take up positions around the temple. This is your chance to end this. Are you ready?
I'll try, but I don't know if I can reach that, much less close it.
No. This rift was the first, and it is the key. Seal it, and perhaps we seal the breach.
Then let's find a way down, and be careful.
Now is the hour of our victory. Bring forth the sacrifice.
Called out to you, but...
What's going on here?
Run while you can! Run them!
We have an intruder. Slay the dwarf.
Attacked. And the Divine, is she... Was this vision true? What are we seeing?
I don't remember.
Echoes of what happened here. The Fade bleeds into this place. This rift is not sealed, but it is closed, albeit temporarily. I believe that with the mark, the rift can be opened, and then sealed properly and safely. However, opening the rift will likely attract attention from the other side.
That means demons! Stand ready!
Dude, the big bad fry demon.
Now!
Yeah, keep that aggro off of me. Now, mind you, I'm gonna be a DPS warrior, not an aggro warrior, so.
Wear it down.
Even now.
The demon is vulnerable! Now!
Well-placed barrier, Solus.
Take
obviously my chain is going to be fairly useful. I don't know how good an idea that was, getting the aggro on me, but... Solus's barrier protected me.
Through the rift.
Ugh, Jesus. The electricity lash killed me. Okay. Drink a potion, Varric. Drink a potion. I just hope she can keep it up. Again. Alright. The only chance I have is to get the disrupt the rift. Not going well at the moment. There we go. Okay, where is Solus? That's a good question. Because Solus is my only mage and I need him up. Cast a barrier, man. There we go. Yes, I know it's AoE. Just get the freaking barrier up. Solus, these guys are just, you know, squishy guys should stay the hell away from the frickin' pride demon and let the tank take care of it. Can I disrupt again? I can. Nothing can do against the demon now, guys, so help me out with these. Barrier up, distract that fucker, and I will attempt to disrupt him. Thank you. I think that was a lot smoother than last time overall. I know what I need to do, even though I'm kind of the opposite of a mage. Whereas Corvina is lithe, skinny, and weak, and wields a staff. I wield, well, obvious.
Oh! I didn't know you were awake, I swear.
Don't worry about it, I only...
I beg your forgiveness and your blessing. I am but a humble servant. You are back in Haven, my lady. They say you saved us. The breach stopped growing, just like the mark on your hand. It's all anyone has talked about for the last 3 days.
Oh, then the danger is over.
The breach is still in the sky, but that's what they say. I'm certain Lady Cassandra would want to know you've wakened. She said, at once.
And where is she?
In the Chantry, with the Lord Chancellor. At once, she said.
That's refreshing. Probably leave it off for here. Just gonna pick up some elf root. And get my armor. I don't really like the look of this armor, to be honest. But it is better than the mercenary armor, obviously, so kind of looks weird as far as the weapon's concerned, I think. Maul, let's see. One is AoE and the other is direct DPS. Thing is, DPS is king. So I'll probably go with this. Like I said, I'm going for,
That's her. Oh. She stopped the breach from getting any bigger.
I probably should meet the council first, eh? Because I do want to respec. For now, I do have 1 point to invest, I think. I think this is useless without the kick them, give them the boot. But otherwise, it's quite good. When it works. I think I'm going to be basically concentrating on Vanguard and the two-handed trees. And hopefully, whatever tank I decide on, that'll be the aggro beast. Nope. Just getting little things here before I go in. There was stuff around here. Disciple lightning staff. That's useful. Give it to, well, I'm not sure what mage I'm gonna be taking. But now, you know, starting the game, I know how to make regeneration potions, which I didn't know before, which was getting me killed a lot, unnecessarily.
Says
gear in the back here. Ring of attack. Better than nothing. Iron. The AoE effect is, in general, a lot more useful. That's why I don't see the immols. I think axe aesthetically goes really great with a dwarf, so that's what I'm going to be. Either hopefully I'll find one, or I'll craft one, or whatever. So still some stuff here to read. Reinforced shield. Schematic. Okay.
I do not believe she is guilty.
Things down here. Helps knowing some of the ins and outs from before. Kunari Great Axe. Well, unfortunately, it still has worse DPS, I believe, than. Yeah, it's inferior in every way. I think it would look a lot cooler, but it's still inferior, so. There'll be axes to come. I really want a big battle axe. There's still something down here. If I were a rogue, I can unlock some of these things, but. Sadly, I am not.
Chain her! I want her prepared for travel to the capital for trial.
Disregard that, and leave us.
Templars.
You walk a dangerous line, Seeker.
The breach is stable, but it is still a threat. I will not ignore it.
I did everything I could to close the breach. It almost killed me.
Yet you live. A convenient result insofar as you're concerned.
Have a care, Chancellor. The breach is not the only threat we face.
Someone was behind the explosion at the Conclave. Someone most holy did not expect. Perhaps they died with the others, or have allies who yet live.
I am a suspect?
You, and many others.
But not the prisoner.
I heard the voices in the temple. The Divine called to her for help.
So her survival, that thing on her hand, all a coincidence.
Providence. The Maker sent her to us in our darkest hour.
Very different personalities,
You really think your Maker would send someone like me?
The Maker does as he wills. It is not for me to say.
Even if that means a dwarf is his chosen?
Humans are not the only people with an interest in the fate of the world.
The breach remains, and your mark is still our only hope of closing it.
This is not for you to decide.
You know what this is, Chancellor. A writ from the Divine, granting us the authority to act. As of this moment, I declare the Inquisition reborn. We will close the breach, we will find those responsible, and we will restore order, with or without your approval.
This is the Divine's directive. Rebuild the Inquisition of old. Find those who will stand against the Chaos. We aren't ready. We have no leader, no numbers, and now no Chantry support.
But we have no choice. We must act now, with you at our side.
What is the Inquisition of old, exactly?
It preceded the Chantry. People who banded together to restore order in a world gone mad.
After, they laid down their banner and formed the Templar Order, but the Templars have lost their way. We need those who can do what must be done united under a single banner once more.
But aren't you still part of the Chantry?
Is that what you see?
The Chantry will take time to find a new divine, and then it will wait for her direction.
But we cannot wait. So many Grand Clerics died at the Conclave. No, we are on our own. Perhaps forever.
If you're truly trying to restore order...
That is the plan.
Help us fix this before it's too late.
This, I will stop and leave it off for here. As you can see, Gunhild is a very different kind of character to Dwarven, I mean. Short and stocky versus short and lithe and skinny. And she's someone who sees the need to take responsibility, even if she might, may or may not be directly responsible. I mean, someone's got to do something. Someone's got to do something about the problem, right? Whereas Corvina's kind of a little bit more scheming, well, a lot more scheming, more interested in assuming power, although she's not a power-hungry maniac, but just very different personalities. Okay, I will leave it off for here. I'm going to do some respeccing in the meantime, and I might do some level grinding, nothing involving important elements of the story, of course, but you know, the kind of stuff. The armor looks pretty cool, but it's not as good as the other. But I'll see you guys the next time, and thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy this playthrough as much as the Corvina one. I'm equally interested in both because they're going to be so different in every way. From the class, to the race, to the attitude. So, more to come. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.